You're watching Movie Guide. Hi, I'm Cheryl Crisp, your host for Backstage Pass, and we have an exclusive interview with 7-time Grammy Award winner Toby Mac, and he opens up about his music, his family, his faith, and his future.
Can't see the wind, but it moves the leaves from the bottom to the top of the tallest trees. You are everything they'll ever need, and they can't take that from me.
You know, I'm just a guy trying to pursue God with all my heart, and some days I'm right behind him, and other days I'm laying by the wayside. And it's all that. It's just all life. I try to write from my own experiences, and I find when I do that, people relate to that better than just me being fictional. Because it's true, you know what I mean? And we're not that different from each other. You know, we all have friends that are going through it, the times we were there for them, the times we failed them. So I like to write about that, and I think it resonates more with people. I did bring DC Talk back together. That's one thing that's very different. And we haven't done anything together in a decade, so that was really interesting. And it was a song that really mattered to me, probably the deepest song on the record. It's kind of a rocker, so it doesn't feel like, oh, you think of deep, you think of ballad. But it's a heavy song, and it is about losing my dad, and it's about my son with MD, and it's really about facing those things and being hands and feet and really serving, being in the trenches of serving, you know, where you can't get out of it, you're not, you know, and it's, you're worn out, you're pushing so hard, it wears you out, but somehow or another, it's fulfilling. I say one of the lines in the song is, empty's never felt so full. You're worn out physically, but your spirit is refreshed by serving somebody and loving them well. Well, I think we need to be in the world, you know, as believers. And I think that faith-based film, faith-based music, it's asking people, and it's causing people to think. It's causing people to have conversations about goodness and loving people well and serving others. And I think any time you can put that in front of people, it could inspire them to do that. I always say I want people to leave my show sweaty, hoarse, but refreshed in their spirit. And that's the same way I think they could leave a film, they maybe not sweaty and hoarse, hopefully not, they're yelling at the screen, but hopefully they leave there refreshed in their spirit. They leave there with their faith increased, their determination to love someone that's their enemy, their determination to reach out to their neighbor and maybe make them dinner one night or pay it forward at a drive-through window. I mean, there's, you know, these films cause us to think about the richness of life, the deeper things, not just the surface, not just the physical. Anytime we can cause people to think about those things and want to live more passionately for those things, it's a good thing for society. Yeah, I have a song on my album called Move. It's called Move, and in parentheses, Keep Walking. And I think it's that. I just meet so many people that feel stuck or that feel down or feel like they're, as I said earlier, lying on the roadside instead of moving, instead of their life moving forward. You know, they've been hurt. They're a victim. They feel like they're a victim. That song means something to me. It's probably my favorite song on the record. And I would say, yeah, listen to Move. Because at some point you gotta get up. At some point you have to move, and you have to trust, and you have to take a step of faith. I call it musical gumbo. You know, and in my gumbo, in my big old pot of musical gumbo, I sprinkle in the soul music and the hip hop and the funk and the rock and roll guitars and maybe just a dash of reggae. I mean, that's what I do. I kind of look at it as, I've played in all those areas so long that I sort of feel maybe I've rite of passage in all of them. I don't ever go all the way there with any of them. I stay, it's sort of this hodgepodge mix of, there's probably a better word than that. That sounds kind of lame, but there's probably like a, I don't know, it's a chemistry that makes music that I love. And I think that you have to love your own music. I think, you know, I'm not like prideful about it, but I think, man, I'm into this. I'm wanting to make music that moves my soul. My goal in this record, you ask a lot about this record, my goal was to, I want every song to make you feel something. And I wasn't going to stop till every song made you feel something.
Toby Mac, and I don't mean to trouble. Feeling fresher than the night at the double. I'm just saying, yo, we heard quite enough of you. We're fine. You're 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 fine